Happening now, the city of Columbus is spending $253 million to build a storm sewer tunnel under the city. Part of that money coming from your water and sewage bills. Tonight, 10TV's Kevin Landers goes underground to explain what the project is designed to solve and why this isn't the last project water customers will need to pay for.
3 miles from downtown Columbus, beneath the bustling streets, a colossal engineering marvel is taking shape. From the 10TV drone, it looks like a wormhole from a sci-fi movie. This is the Lower Olentangy Tunnel. To get to the bottom, we descended by crane 80 feet below the city. To get to the end of the 2.5 mile tunnel, we squeezed inside an electric train down a 12-foot wide space that will take us to the star of the show, a $16 million cutting blade. When completed, this tunnel will stretch 3.5 miles. Dave Chotska is the project manager.
Right now, if you were to have a large rain flow, all of your sewer and your storm water run into the same pipe, and they're not big enough to handle the capacity.
The Lower Olentangy Tunnel is designed to solve a pressing environmental problem, keeping storm water from overwhelming sewer lines and ending up in the Olentangy River.
How much water will this tunnel displace that we normally would be sent to the river, but now it won't go there?
On a typical year, about 100, 140 million gallons of wastewater that won't go to the rivers.
This consent order by the Ohio EPA found the city of Columbus in violation of water pollution laws in the state of Ohio. That forced Columbus to build a tunnel to fix the problems in the Olentangy River. As a result, Columbus sewer users had to pay higher fees to pay for it.
A lot of your sewers now are outdated, and so it grows as an improvement to your system.
What's captured in the tunnel will eventually be pumped to the city's wastewater treatment plant, then treated and sent back into the Olentangy River.
After this tunnel is built and it's functioning, are we to expect that the Olentangy will be a cleaner river?
Yes, yeah, and the Scioto.
With a completion date of June of 2026, the city says the project is on time, but we're just getting started.
Is this the last of the tunnels that we have to build, or will we have to build more?
We'll likely have to build more. Our population's growing. You know, our sewer system, a lot of these areas are 80 to 100 years old. They were never intended to carry the population we have.
For now, the project remains out of sight for most Columbus residents, but the city believes its impact will be felt for years to come.
It's going to help, you know, future generations keep the rivers clean.
Kevin Landers, 10TV News.
Well, Columbus water customers began paying higher sewer rates when the Ohio EPA consent order took effect, and that was back in 2004. But in less than a month, customers will see their water bills go up 6%. That's $55 each year. The increase will help offset the cost of future water projects, including the construction of the city's fourth water treatment plant.